Hey there, it's Mike. Thanks for checking out this video on my channel, and we're gonna get to the desktop in just a second here, but I just wanna talk about single exposure real estate photography. Okay, there's been a lot of attention given to, and I've done it myself plenty of times, and obviously I'm not against it, but multiple shots, bracketing, layering, things like that. But I'm gonna show you a house that I just did in Green Bay a few days ago, and how many shots I was able to just do single exposure, just using one light, working with ambient and Lightroom and things like that. So let's just go through the house. This isn't really an editing video, but I'm just gonna walk you through a bunch of my shots, explain how I did them, okay? So let's go to Lightroom here. And this first shot here is second angle of a living room. I let the window light behind me light up this whole living room. There's a window and lighting of this. I don't need to light this up. And all I did was go over here with my 8200, trigger the camera, boom, single exposure, that's it. Here, I let the ambient expose this area. This got a little dark over here, so I popped the light over here, maybe 16th of a power, a little bit more than that maybe, and that's it, single exposure done, okay? Now this could seem really daunting and like complicated, but when there's side light like this, there's no window exposure to worry about, like how dark is it or bright is it, whatever. I let the side light kick in. I'm really exposing for this area down here because it's the darkest, and then Lightroom, I just kind of darken this area up a little bit, and that's it. I don't even know if I use my 8200 and lit this. This is all ambient. Okay, single exposure. Here I just bounced the 8200 up, 16th of a power maybe, lighten up these shadows a little bit. There's a window over here. It's lighting almost the entire room. No need to go into the kitchen or the bathroom. This bathroom's being completely lit by the window in there. No need to go in there. Boom, single exposure. This one's a little bit trickier. I use the ambient, the window light that's in this living room to expose this. This got pretty dark, so I pointed my 8200 up right there and brighten this up, and that's it. You see fluorescent tube lights in a basement. I'm like, hey, this is great. This is gonna be quick. So these three shots were just, you know, overexposing a little bit, taking advantage of that, of these tube lights here. This one, I think I pointed 8200 up a little bit behind me, like 16th of a power, just to bring this up a little bit. But again, single exposure, okay? Once I went upstairs to the bedrooms, this one was lit by the window off to the right. I lit the actual bedroom up with that. No need to light up this. Bright enough, they don't need to see inside a small closet. I'm in the bathroom here. I think I have one leg over on each side of the toilet because it's pretty small, and I'm standing there with my 8200, about eighth of a power, lightening that up. That's it, single exposure, no bracketing, no layering, no Photoshop. Here it's just 8200 pointed above, lighting this whole thing, boom, done. Okay, the agent wanted this small closet photographed by itself, so I just did a couple of, I think I turned the light on and just shot it and maybe used a little bit of the 8200 here to just brighten up, take away the color temperature issues, and that was it, single exposure. Here, I didn't even need the 8200. There's a window right behind me. I just use that, expose it, done. A little bit of an 8200 here, exposing, lightening up this, but there's no window to worry about. I let the window light just expose that, done. Same thing here, window light, done. No need for the flash. Here, the window light, as you can see, it's starting to get a little blown out over here. It's still workable. I used the 8200 to brighten up this just a little bit, but single exposure, okay? So, I mean, I single exposure 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 of the shots. I did not have to layer, I did not have to bracket, I didn't have to take the Photoshop. It's something I look for and I aim for when I'm doing real estate stuff. You know, it's gonna make you more efficient on site. It's definitely gonna cut down your time in post when you're just tweaking in Lightroom and that's it. So something to keep an eye out for, something to strive for. If you can get away with one shot, use as much ambient as possible until things start to get a little too blown out, then bring it back a tad. Any areas that are maybe a little bit dark, Maybe just lighten up the shadows a little bit, control the color temperature with your flash, and you're good to go. So that's a tip. Don't think that every shot has to be this complicated, you know, multiple shots, and I have to bracket and I have to layer and use the brush and all that stuff. For real estate stuff, don't beat yourself up. You know, if you can do it in one exposure, something to shoot for. So definitely I would look at maybe start doing that. So I hope that helps you out. Give me a thumbs up. Got to get my other glasses on here. Those are my editing glasses. These are my normal glasses. Give me a thumbs up if this helped you. Check out my links below. You can donate to my channel. Any amount gets you a video with an entire edit, about 40 minutes long, of a new construction home I did a couple months ago. Otherwise, check out my websites, all my other stuff, my gear list, etc., etc. Until I talk to you soon, I hope you have a great day. Keep making and taking great photos. We'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.